Rett syndrome is caused by mutations in a gene called MECP2. But what if there was a way to bypass those mutations? An exciting, innovative technology is being harnessed by the lab of Stuart Cobb to achieve just that. In fact, we're so enthusiastic about this approach that we've awarded over $1 million to his lab at the University of Edinburgh to specifically support this work. So what is this technology? It's called splicosome-mediated RNA transplicing, or SMART for short. It's a mouthful, we know. But don't let the name scare you. We know that DNA contains the full set of instructions for a cell to make a protein, and that RNA is the intermediate step between the DNA and the protein. Think of the RNA as a courier who shuttles the DNA code from the brain of the cell, the nucleus, to the factory of the cell, the ribosome, where the protein is assembled. Let's take a closer look at what happens in the nucleus before the RNA is shuttled. The MECP2 gene is made up of alternating regions called exons and introns. Inside the nucleus, the introns, an unnecessary exon, are cut out so the remaining exons can be spliced together with the help of a molecular machine called the spliceosome, hence the name splicosome-mediated RNA transplicing, or SMART. Now, here comes the really exciting part. The spliceosome's normal process can be hijacked and used to our advantage by splicing out the exons that contain mutations and splicing in healthy exons that are delivered via vector. There are two big advantages to the SMART approach. One, it can never result in too much MECP2 being produced. And two, it can correct 97% of all Rett syndrome mutations. And we think that's smart.